Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. In this video, we shall demonstrate how to calculate the latent heat of an object from a cooling curve or a heating curve. We shall use idealized curves, which consist of straight lines only. The diagram shows a typical cooling curve. It consists of five paths, A, B, C, D, and E. The curve represents a gas being cooled from A until it becomes a solid at E. For simplicity, we shall assume that heat is lost at a constant rate. In other words, the power of heat loss is a constant. At B, the gas is condensing into a liquid. It is a mixture of gas and liquid. The temperature T1 is the boiling point of the substance. At C, the gas has completely turned into a liquid. When it reaches D, the liquid is freezing into a solid. It is a mixture of liquid and solid. The temperature T2 represents the melting point of the substance. At E, the liquid has completely turned into a solid. It will remain in solid form when it is cooled further. Suppose the rate of heat loss is P. From the time intervals TB and TD, we can calculate the latent heat of vaporization and latent heat of fusion of the object. The latent heat of vaporization is QV equal to P times TB, and the latent heat of fusion is QF equal to P times TD. Let's look at a cooling curve with numerical values. Example 1. The graph shows the cooling curve of substance X. A. Find the boiling point and melting point of X. B. If the rate of heat loss is 100 watts throughout the process, find 1. The latent heat of vaporization, and 2. The latent heat of fusion. Solution. The object is a gas between T equal to 0 and T equal to 30 seconds. It condenses between T equal to 30 seconds and T equal to 80 seconds. It is a liquid between T equal to 80 seconds and T equal to 110 seconds. It freezes between T equal to 110 seconds and 180 seconds. Afterwards, it is a solid. Therefore, the boiling point of X is 90 degrees Celsius, and the melting point is 50 degrees Celsius. The time for condensation is T1 equal to 80 minus 30 equal to 50 seconds. By power equal to energy divided by time, P equal to Q divided by T. The latent heat of vaporization of X is QV equal to P times T1 equal to 100 times 50 equal to 5000 joules. Similarly, the time for freezing is T2 equal to 180 minus 110 equal to 70 seconds. The latent heat of fusion of X is QF equal to P times T2 equal to 100 times 70 equal to 7000 joules. Let's look at another example. Example 2. Liquid Y is being heated by a heater. The graph shows how its temperature varies with time. A. What happens to Y from T equal to 3 minutes to T equal to 9 minutes? B. Given that the latent heat of fusion of Y is 3.2 times 10 to the power 4 joule and the latent heat of vaporization is 4.8 times 10 to the power 4 joule, estimate the power output of the heater. Solution. A. During the time interval from T equal to 3 minutes to T equal to 9 minutes, liquid Y vaporizes into a gas. It is a mixture of liquid and gas. B. Since Y changes from liquid to gas, we should use the latent heat of vaporization. That is, heat supply is Q equal to 4.8 times 10 to the power 4 joule. The time for vaporization is T equal to 9 minus 3 equal to 6 minutes equal to 6 times 60 seconds equal to 360 seconds. Therefore, the power of the heater is P equal to Q divided by T equal to 4.8 times 10 to the power 4 divided by 360 equal to 133 watts. In this video, you have learned how to estimate the latent heat of an object from a cooling curve or a heating curve, provided the rate of heat exchange is known. The method is to find the time for phase change and apply the formula for power. Question. The graph shows how an object is heated from solid until it becomes a gas. Arrange the state of matter of the object in ascending order of specific heat capacity of the substance. Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are welcome to comment on the answers of other people. I hope this video can help you understand more about calculating latent heat from a cooling curve. Thank you for watching.